So this is my last time having a birthday in my 60s.
Yeah.
Yep. So I'm going to celebrate really differently. New decade.
Well, anyways, I'll just sing happy birthday. So, bye.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Change. Just relax. Take it easy. You're still young. That's your fault. There's so much you have to know. Find a girl, settle down. If you want, you can marry. Look at me. I am old, but I'm happy. I was once like you are now, and I know that it's not easy to be calm when you found something going on. But take your time, think a lot. Why, think of everything you've got, for you will still be here tomorrow, but your dreams may not. How can I try to explain? When I do, he turns away again. It's always been the same, same old story. From the moment I could talk, I was ordered to listen. Now there's a way, and I know that I have to go away. I know.
Assalamu alaikum, Mom. Wishing you a happy birthday. And I'll do also just a quick update on me. I think you know I was out in Michigan for my birthday. It was really nice. And then I came back and started looking for apartments because I was, planning to move. And we had talked some about the plans around, maybe Buenos Aires and moving out of New York. And I've been working in, with the business that I started, and have been doing more and more technical work, and have spent the last 3 years doing increasingly more programming. So initially for the website, I rebuilt a bunch of stuff and some, newer modern web technologies as a way to teach myself. I was working on a completely new project that I built from the ground up, and tried to launch as a standalone website, and that was a program that I built to do basically help companies manage their user reviews. So when someone reviews a website. And I use it on our course. Somebody like leaves a review for our course. Having a way to manage and display those on your website, which was an okay idea. Not necessarily a great idea, but an okay idea. And then go back to working on the website. So I'm a little bit in between that now. And then, of course, I still have the language stuff, the language, 1 month Spanish, 1 month French, which I just don't spend a lot of time on anymore, but still, still creates some income, still creates income. So that's what keeps, and right now enough just to keep the lights on, and keep rent paid. I hope that, is somewhat illuminating. And so hopefully I'll be talking to you later on today, inshallah. I hope you're enjoying your birthday.
Hi, my name is Mariam Husna, and I wanted to tell you a little bit about who I am and what I do. And who I am and what I do are very much intertwined. So a little bit about me. I am highly sensitive, intuitive. This is something that I spent most of my life not knowing. And at some point along the way, I discovered this idea of the trait of high sensitivity, and I started to be able to put the pieces together and make sense of my life. I celebrated the 4-year anniversary last night of my online school. I actually created a school several years ago to train, educate, and mentor people about the trait of high sensitivity and about intuitive gifts and extrasensory abilities. So most of my life, I thought my sensitivity was something that was wrong with me. And it wasn't until I actually learned how to work with it in a very skillful way that I was able to see what it actually is all about. And I felt so just like on purpose when I learned about how to work with my sensitivity that I started to just share and write and speak about it. And eventually I just noticed that there was a really great need for people to receive this information. So I used to do a lot of private client work, and then eventually that became unsustainable. And then I created my school where we have a thriving community of people who are highly sensitive, who are supporting our close friends with family members of someone who are highly sensitive and they want to learn more about it, as well as people who see the world just through a different lens and through the lens of more of the non-ordinary reality, more of the dimensions and layers and realms that go beyond the world of form. And so I teach people how to navigate those realms skillfully, with the appropriate boundaries, being appropriately grounded, and being able to understand what is our own energy and what is not our own energy is one of the most important things that I could ever teach someone. A lot of times when we are very open channels, we tend to pick up on other people's energies and merge with them and enmesh with their energy fields and become very confused about why we're feeling what we're feeling. And oftentimes it actually is not our own, is not our energy. So instead of sometimes this approach of, you know, you have to process everything you're feeling, actually when you're holding on to energy that doesn't belong to you, the most skillful way to actually work with it is to release it, because you actually can't do other people's work. So there are just certain frameworks that I have myself learned through studying multiple different energy systems and healing modalities, and then training with my teachers and my mentors who have been supporting me. And I think that there's just so many great ways that we can add to our toolkit of how to be skillful in the world as we exchange energy with other people, as we interact with other people. And then the last thing that I'll say is I also am a flower priestess and a plant medicine teacher. I do journeys with flowers because flowers are very important teachers actually in this work of high sensitivity. So a lot of the energies that we work with when we do flower journeys are the devas and the elementals of the flower kingdoms and nature spirits and the land spirits. And these energies and these beings know a lot about the human body because they are in collaboration with actually how our body gets created through their templates and the blueprints that they provide. So in order to heal and restore our original templates, flowers are just a really great mirror for us to understand where we have gotten a little bit distorted in our understanding about some of these concepts and some of these ideas. And so, yeah, those are the things that I do. This is my third year growing a flower garden that I have where I make my own medicine and provide that for my community and my family. So I hope learning about me was helpful. Take care.
I'm your grandson. I have 2 cats, and happy birthday.
Anything else you want to say?
No.
Okay. All right. So I'm producing this video for a couple reasons. One, because my mom asked me to share a little bit about my work, to share with her network. As a diversity, equity, and inclusion consultant, I help businesses and organizations to level up in terms of their internal policies and legal standards and training I also help with like empowerment workshops for marginalized communities to uncover internal bias and heal intergenerational trauma. So of course I came on here to share about myself, and as I mentioned with the trauma, I integrate energy healing technologies and methodologies that have been well researched into my work to weave in a somatic and trauma-informed component to this anti-oppression based consulting. But another more important reason for this video is to say happy birthday to my mom, who is such an incredible human being and one of my three heroes, along with Bruce Lee and Albert Einstein. And I'm grateful for the opportunity because I think it's sometimes hard to put into words in person with people that we care so deeply about how much they mean to us. And I just don't think that she hears it enough, at least in her own family, but I think my mom is a rock star. And she has contributed so much to us being shining lights and beacons in the world as her children and the grandchildren who are our seeds. And I just don't have enough of the eloquence even to gather in all the moments that I have little light bulbs or ahas or sparkling sensations of ways that I have learned from my mother that have created ease in my life. And so she's quickly approaching 70, but not quite there yet. It's still every birthday, every moment on this earth is precious, and I'm so, so grateful that my mother is on this earth and that she's celebrating another birthday. And that she has called from us to shine our light and to share our selves in this way as a birthday present. So I love you, Mom, so much.
Hey, Grandma. I just want to say that I'm living with my dad now, you know. And...
Smile, smile.
Bye.
Happy birthday. Which one is this? Like your 64th? 65th? But yeah, it's doing great. My mom found a great school. I have a great school program my dad helped me get into. I love my scooter he got me. I use it all the time. I made a new friend. Yeah, everything's doing great, and see you later.
My mom, for her birthday, she wanted her siblings to explain or talk about themselves and tell us about our lives. This is my daughter, Paloma. She just turned 8 years old. And I'm Khalil, I'm her father. I am currently 36. Let's see. A little bit about me is I teach a fitness class. A few days a week, and it is very fun. I personally feel like it's good for the soul. I really enjoy working out because it makes me feel good emotionally. I also run a small business. It's completely digital. It's online. The product that I sell is socks. I've been featured on the New York Post, Harper's Bazaar, and I should be in Esquire this month. Fingers crossed, they did give me the confirmation. So happy birthday, Mom. I'll be in Esquire. In addition to that, I really love spending time with Paloma. We like to go on bike rides for ice cream, and she just started soccer. I'm trying to think if there's more about me that I should be talking about. I currently live in Oakland, California. Before that, I lived in Washington, D.C. I love to travel, and I'm very fond of any kind of ethnic cuisine, albeit Ethiopian or Laos, Cambodian. I love ethnic cuisine. And this is my daughter Paloma again. She's 8 and she just started soccer. She's currently in swim, and I think she might be starting piano.
Can I say my thing?
Of course, I'm sorry.
You know, it is Paloma. I'm 8. I'm in soccer. I'm in swim. I'm going to start piano, and I'm starting choir tomorrow.
She's doing more than me.
I'm now in third grade, and my teacher's name is Miss Grace, and I would say I'm really into singing and dancing and long road trips to see my uncle.
Is that all you want to say? Okay. Hi, Mom. Bye, Mom. Love you, Mom. Happy birthday, Mom.
Happy birthday, Nana.
All right.
Okay, Mom. This is the cocktail bar that I work at. Called Drexel. Very pretty. Okay, Mom. So this is Paloma's soccer game. She just got checked in. She's got Paloma on the back of her jersey.
Yeah, homie, we live. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Nana on her birthday. Sam, fam, we in here. We live. Happy birthday, yo. You know how we do? Ain't that right?
Hey! I love you. Happy birthday. Love you.
This is the house full of boys. I miss all the women. Don't hurt him.